Hello everyone, and thanks for watching this video tutorial. Here today's topic is Computer Science 2210 Paper 2, Problem Solving Skills on Pre-Release Material. Now this paper consists of three sections, three tasks, task 1, task 2 and task 3, with two sections, section A and section B. In section A, now coming on to the section A, you are advised to spend no longer than 40 minutes answering this section. That means if you have prior knowledge on attempting these types of questions, or if you have programming background, so at least not more than 40 minutes you have to concentrate to complete this task within 40 minutes. Now the next message, do not attempt task 1, 2 and 3 now. Use the pre-release material and your experience from attempting the task before the examination to answer one question 1. Now see that the task 1, a data logger records the temperature on the roof of school twice a day at midday and midnight. Input and store the temperatures recorded for a month. You must store the temperatures in two one-dimensional. Here understand the word two one-dimensional. That means you have to declare two separate arrays with one-dimensional status. One for the midday temperature and one for the midnight temperature. All the temperatures must be validated on entry and any invalid temperatures rejected. You must decide your own validation rules. You may assume that there are 30 days in a month. Now they have defined simply what you have to do. You have to declare the arrays separately, two different arrays. It could be midday temperatures or it could be midnight temperatures, with the range of 30 days repetitions. Now coming on to the task 2, to understand the question, calculate the average temperature for midday and the average temperature for midnight. That means you have to separately calculate the temperature for midday and the separate calculation for midnight, and then you have to calculate the average of midday and midnight. And you have to output these averages with a suitable message for each one. Now in task 3, what you are required to do, select the day with the highest midday. That means what was the highest temperature in the midday. You have to store that thing. And the day with the lowest midnight temperature. And the whole day you have to record the midnight temperature, the lowest midnight temperature. Then you have to output each of these temperatures, the corresponding day and a suitable message. Now I am reading the task 3 again. Select the day with the highest midday temperature. That means you have to store the midday temperature when it is maximum, and the day with the lowest midnight temperature when it is the least value during midnight. Then output each of those temperatures, the corresponding day and a suitable message. Now your program must include appropriate prompts for the entry of data. Here you are required to prompt the user with proper messages, and to prompt, let's suppose, taking the values and something like that, with the error messages and other outputs need to be set out clearly and understandably. All variables, constants and other identifiers must have meaningful names. Each task must be fully tested. Here you are required to declare all the variables in a way that their names should be meaningful. That means, for example, if you are declaring the midday variable or midnight variable, even you can declare with the full name MID, mid, DAY, day, midday, TEMP, ERE, TURE, temperature, or TEMP. It's up to you, but it should have meanings. So continue with the next. The question number 1 in relation to this pre-release material. Now see. Now you can see the question. Question 1, part A, all variables, constants and other identifiers should have meaningful names. Here you have to understand task 1 only. In task 1, you had to store the midday temperatures and midnight temperatures in array. That means you have to declare total number of arrays for 1 month as you have studied the task 1 in pre-release material. Now here the solution can be, let's suppose it could be your given name. I have kept it my M day, that means midday temperature, midday M day TMP 1:30, that means 1 till 30, that means it has a place or location 30 locations from 1 till 30, or you can declare as midday TMP 0 to 29 or midday temp MT as well. You can see the empty declaration of the midday TMP with the empty square box, or midday TMP 30 directly, or midday TMP